today's chaining class. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to put on chains. We've got the chain, the double chain. This is called a triple rail chain, or a double chain because it covers two tires, but it has three of these, which are referred to as the rails. These two over here are the single chains. Most people use single chains more often. They're more commonly used, so I'll demonstrate the use of those. And we're also going to go over the kind of things that you need to do to begin, because just putting the chains on is like step number 5 or 6, okay? So I'm going to go over what you need to look for, how to check your chains, the tools that you need to have, and then we're actually going to run into the demonstration. I'll show you the installing the triple rail chain and then installing the single chain. And along with that, we're going to cover other topics like how to untangle a chain and why we lay our chains out and look at them the way that we do when we initially get in a truck. We don't just assume that we have what we need. All right, so when you're initially assigned a tractor, you don't want to assume that you have the chains and the tools that you need. You need to actually pull everything off and look at them. Here I've laid out a couple of chains, and this is what I want you to do. Take all the chains off the truck that you're assigned and lay them out just like this, side by side. Once a chain is out of a bag, it doesn't have numbers on it. And so the only way to tell that they are the same size chain is to see that they are the same length, they've got the same number of cross rails, they're the same width. When chains are in a bag, you can see that one pair, it's listed that there are several different tire sizes that they fit. So the fit is very important. If you get a chain that is too big for your tires, this is not going to work. It's not going to be effective. It'll come off. It can cause a lot of damage. So we need to know that they fit properly. So check your chains to make sure that they're the same size. How we know that the chains are going to fit is that you've checked to see they're all the same size to begin with, and then practice. You have to put the chain on your tire. See if it fits. If the one chain fits, then all of the chains are going to fit. So that's how we know. Once they're out of the bag, there's just no other way. So part of checking your chains was making sure that they were straight, and I want to clarify and define that right now. When you lay these chains out, they may look straight to the untrained eye, but what we are looking for is a twist in the chain. Where the chain is twisted is where it's going to break. It becomes a weak spot in the chain. It also makes them more difficult to install. So if we look along here, we can see that most of the links are just like this, down into the backside, down in the backside. Now we come here and we see that these are folded up over the top here. You may even notice that this cam is backward to that cam. So this tells me that I've got a twist in the chain. So in order to straighten the chain out, I'll take that twist and I'll put that link to where it needs to be. Now notice what happens right here. This pulls up like that. If we pull that up, you can see the chain is pulling in this direction. And that is what tells me how the chain is twisted. And all I need to do is take this link here, grab the chain, and pull it through itself. When I straighten this out, if you look down the length of this entire chain, you're going to see every single one of these links in the position that it's supposed to be in. Now, if you look at this chain over here, are you seeing where the twist is? When you know what to look for, you're immediately going to see it. So if we straighten this out the way it's supposed to be, well, right here is the twist. And now you have a trained eye, you know what to look for and how to untangle the chain. So practice, I cannot emphasize the need for practice enough, because this tells you more than anybody can just tell you. So once we've taken all of our chains off, we've laid them out, we've laid them side by side, and we see that they all are the same size, then we're going to also go and make sure that we have the tools that we need. You're going to need 18 to 24 bungees. Bungees come in varying sizes. So 18 to 24. This bungee is actually too long to use to chain with, because it's not going to put any tension against the tires. These shorter ones, we're going to need more of them, but I'll show that how to properly install that as part of the demonstration. Now, chaining tools. We have rail tighteners that are called cams, and these are your cam tools. This is an L cam. and a T-cam. So the different tools are used for different sizes. If you have a double cam chain, you're always going to need one of these, but they're both very handy, and I'll show you how to use these chains to tighten up your chains. Some tools that aren't provided most of the time, but these are really handy to have, are a small fifth wheel puller and an actual chain hammer. Now, an actual chain hammer is really handy to have because oftentimes when you go to chain, you've already been running in the snow and ice. And because we don't drop our trailer in order to chain, we've got that trailer right up over the top here. And if you've been driving in the snow and the ice, you may have a lot of snow and ice built up right up above your tires. And in order to get some space, you may need to pick that ice and snow out from above your tires. So having something like this that is designed not only as a cam tool to work in the cams, the ends, but it's a really handy pick to remove ice and snow so that you can actually get some space to work with around your tires. These are a really handy thing to have, but not necessary, because you can do the job with just this and some other tools you may have. You also want to make sure that you have a flashlight. And last but not least, I am not going to stress enough the proper gloves. You've got to have the proper gloves for what you're doing. Padded gloves might keep your hands warm, but you're going to fumble around in them. And the longer that we sit roadside, the more danger that we're in. So we want to be able to move quickly and efficiently, and that's not going to be served with the wrong kind of gloves. If you have gloves that are leather, the moment that they get moist, then they're going to get slimy and sloppy, and then you won't be able to grip the chain and manipulate it like you need to. Another tool that you want to have is a mat or something to lay down on the ground. This is just a regular old yoga mat. You can get these at Walmart or Target or any of the big box stores in the exercise section, about $7-$8, and it is an amazing assistant to being down on the ground and not getting too soaked and nasty. So once you've checked that you have all the tools that you have the chains that you need, then you do your practice run. During your practice run, you're going to determine the fit of your chain. You're going to use the tools. That practice that you do using those tools and manipulating the equipment is going to tell you a lot about how you're going to handle chaining. When it comes to the decision to chain roadside, or when you are required to chain, if you've already done this practice, you are going to be so much more comfortable with the process. So instead of making a decision whether or not to chain based on your own competency, you're going to be making that decision to chain based on the weather conditions and the safety conditions, which is that primary focus. The triple chains cannot get twisted like the double chains can get twisted. The only place they really twist is right here, which can cause a big problem when you're attempting to hook it up. So if this is twisted, then this cam will flip over like that. You simply pull this around and that will straighten the chain out. So in that aspect, the double chain is easier than the single. The only way that the double chain is easier than the single is that they don't get twisted. So now that we've confirmed that we have all the chains that we need, we have the chain straight, we have all of our chains are the same size and width, then we want to do our practice. I'm going to begin with a demonstration of the double chain. Now, it's very important when you install a chain that it be installed upside right. Where these hooks are, you can see these little hooks, that goes outward. This is the surface that hits the pavement. It's very important that you don't put this down toward the tire, because these little hook areas, they will dig into the tire and can cause severe sidewall damage. We definitely don't want that to happen. So when we're looking to install our chain, the proper alignment is for this to be the part that's going to hit the pavement. Now, when you have cams on a chain, the cams go to the outside of the tire, because that's where we're going to be working with them. If we have a chain that has cams on both sides, it's not going to matter which way you put this chain on the tire, but it will definitely still matter that you put that with the hooks upward. Now, today I'm demonstrating with the cam arm chain. This mechanism right here, it can be very confusing. It's my favorite chain to use, but if you don't know how it works, it would be really difficult, and so I want to show you during the demonstration how that works. Other chains are just going to have these hooks here, and that's nice and simple, and they are secure. This one just gives us the ability to have the chain a little bit tighter. All right, so if you're roadside and you've had to straighten your chain out, you're going to start like this. It'll be important to make sure you're folding it over so that the hooks that go to the outside, this is going to hit the pavement. We're going to fold this over so that all of that is together. Then I'm going to find about the center of the chain here to this side. I want to be to this side because these have to go to the outside. Grab that center, bring that weight right up into my body so I can lift with my legs, lift that up. We bring this over to the tire that we're going to use. I'm going to brace one foot here, other foot here. And now remember, we've got a trailer up over the top here, so I can't just put them on. So I'm going to slip this chain over that tire with as little space as I have. Kick that, free up my hand. And pull that over. Now I need to make sure the chain is even side to side. Because we don't have this chain marked for center, I'm going to lay this out looking at this rail here and over here. Now we see how this is basically dangling. It's not even got any slack, but that is kind of pulled up over there on that side. That means on that direction just a little too much. So I'm going to come over here. And we remember, we're working with that trailer over the top, so I just kind of pretend that I don't have all this space. I'm going to lift the chain just a little bit and then pinch it with my leg and then work that slack that direction. And it only takes a little bit to move that chain where you're going to need it. Now that we can see that we're even side to side, we're going to go over the top with this rail here. And as we're doing every one of these processes, we're going to continue making sure that our cams have remained open and that we're not twisting anything. So now I want to pull this chain over the top of that tire, and I definitely do not want to drop it down. So I'm going to come in here with what space I have to work with and pull it over the top. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to make sure that the chain is even side to side. So if I have something like this going on, that's not good. I'm going to relieve that pressure, and you can do this by feel. You can just reach down there and feel how far down you are. If you need to adjust side to side, you're just going to feel for it. You got to do the same thing to the inside. Just reach in, see where that rail is. Everything needs to be pretty much even. And once we've confirmed that we are even this direction and this direction, we'll move on to connecting the rails. So it's very important when we're hooking a chain with the drape method that we're showing you today that we always connect the chain link that is in between the tires first. Whether it's a double chain like this one or it's a single chain just going over one side of the tire, we have to connect this first. The complication is you don't have a lot of room between the tires, and so we've got to find a way to get the links hooked all the way to the bottom, bring those together, the link and the hook together to make that connection. Then we're going to move to the inside and connect that as well. So take a look while I hook up this inside. I'll show you a couple of methods for getting the links over to you. And we're going to start with the bungee cord. If you don't have a fifth wheel puller, you can hook a bungee to the end of your links and then take that bungee and feed it over to yourself so that you can pull those links to you. If you do have a fifth wheel puller like the one I've got, we can just use that fifth wheel puller by staging the links right here where we can reach through the tires, grab them, and pull them over to us with the puller. We're going to demonstrate that.
All right, I'm reaching in now with the fifth wheel puller, grabbed those links, and I'm pulling them over to me. In this hand, I've got the hook. You can see how I'm pulling the chain upward. I'm going to bring the hook in as far as I can reach and drop it into the link, the tightest link that I can reach. And then I release the rest of the chain with a fifth wheel puller. All right, so from the inside, I'm going to reach around and grab that I staged, bring that over to me here. See, if it gets loose, you can always reach over there and grab it again. And I'm going to take the hook, and this is basically the same thing I was doing to the inside of the tire, only I've got more room to work. If I'm to the inside of the tire, I'm doing something more like this. And in this case, I come out here, I want to see, well, I can almost get this link, so I'm going to just check and see if maybe by pulling and tugging over here, I can get just a little bit more slack. And I did. So now, it's a little bit of a fight, but there we go. We're hooked.
The next step that we're going to take in chaining the tire is putting the bungees on. It is absolutely necessary for safety to put the bungees on. There's two worlds of thought. One says that if the chain is properly installed, you don't need bungees. The other chain of thought is, well, if you put bungees on there, they'll hold the chain on if it loosens up. And the reality is the bungees just don't have enough strength to hold the chain on the tire. But if a chain, even properly installed, breaks, if it loosens up to the point where it's going to come off the truck, it needs to come this direction. And the spinning chain could go either ways. When we put the bungees on out here, we are creating a force that brings these rails closer together, which in effect pulls the chain toward the outside. For a triple rail chain, you would want three or four small bungees to create enough force to absolutely be sure that this is going to be drug off the tire. If you're just doing a single chain, just two bungees. So if you kind of think about it, the number of rails matters, how heavy the chain matters. Something like this is good. Those spider bungees are good as long as you are using them. It's very important. A lot of damage can happen if these things move inward. And we want to avoid that. One last thing a lot of people ask about is this stuff here. If this is long enough, it can actually flail out, makes a lot of noise, and hits things. So you can take a spare bungee, hook that in with the spare bungee, and then just hook that bungee over so that it doesn't make a lot of noise. All right, so because most drivers are installing singles, I wanted to demonstrate that really quickly too. These singles are not as heavy as the big doubles, but we are going to use some of the same things. We do want to try to grab for the center. Again, it would be good if you've got some paint to mark your chains with, but other than that, they're a lot easier to handle, which is why they get used more than anything else. So just like the double, we got to remember that we don't have the space to just walk up here and put it on. We've got a trailer there. So I'm going to use the same kind of a thing, brace myself, and then just kind of fling that inner link up over. And keep watching yourself. Make sure that as you're doing this, you're always looking to see that these hooks are to the outside, and as you're working the entire chain, that the cams are open. At this point, it's really easy for these little guys to twist around like that, which is going to make your life hell. So we're going to be watching to see that that chain stays straight and flush while you're doing this. Otherwise, you're going to make your life a little bit miserable until you figure out that your chain is twisted. Now I'm laying these loops out where they'll be easy to reach. And come down here in between that tire. Drop that link through. All right, so
Since we've got the inside hooked properly, we're going to come out to the outside and again try to pick our swivel joint, and it's going to be this one here. So flip that swivel over. That feels a little loose, so in spite of my first guess, I'm going to try for that next one because of how loose that felt. Oh, look, that worked. All right, sometimes you have to double check yourself. Make that connection happen there. Got a pretty big tail. Now we're going to again start with the lowest cam. And you see, you have no idea how a chain is going to fit until you put it on there. That was all I could do with this tool to get that cam to turn. So the only way I could get this cam is if I either had a cheater bar or I'm going to use the bigger, heavier tool. And that means that this chain, the fit, even though it's basically sized the same, and these are the same size tires, I'm only going to be able to get two cams max to begin with, and the chain's as tight as it can go. So let's go ahead and get that tight. And rubber's on. All right, I'm going to go ahead and start bungeeing this single by taking this loose link and just keeping that from flapping around. And then I'll make a good X pattern here. Note that just like the chains, the bungees have kind of a big side and a small side. When we're hooking these bungees in, we need them either to go flush like this one here did, or like this end, the big side out. So I'm going to take the big side out, hook it in so that the small side, if anything is pointed toward the sidewall, the small side is pointed toward the sidewall. So we're going to hook that in just like this. We can bring this over. And again, we've got the small side pointed toward the sidewall and the big side out. And that is a properly bungeed and installed chain. All right, so when it comes time to take the chains off your truck, what you're going to find is you pull off at the chain off area, and as likely as not, when you stop, you're going to find that this is exactly the situation you're in. And if you've been rolling on these chains, the truck is actually going to be on these two rails. You will not be able to get the chain unhooked in this position. Even if it's just over this way a little bit or just over this way a little bit, it can be impossible to get the chain unhooked. So I'm going to take something, anything, and today I have one of these, so I'm going to take this little flag right here and flag where my hook is. Now I'm going to roll forward and I'm going to watch this flag move up into this area so that I can see that I now have all of the hooks in the area where I have the most space to work with. All right, now that I've got all of this in an area that I can work with it, that's when I'm going to grab my bungees, take the bungees down, loosen all the cams, and then go for the rails. And now I have the ability to work in that space where I have the room to do that. We would, of course, be removing more bungees than this, but for the sake of this demonstration, we've only got the one. And it does not matter which cam you start with, just get them all loose. And just like with the cams, at this point we are going to work from the outside to the inside. We don't have to worry about going to the inside first. We're going to need to move this piece of chain out of the way because when we roll forward, we don't want to roll on top of it with this. So what I've done there is I've made sure that there aren't things like this happening. I'm not going to be rolling the truck over that. I've pulled the chain flush so that all parts of it are flat. So we're going to make that flush. Once you've taken all your chains and you've positioned them just like this, now we can roll forward off the chains without damaging anything, and they'll be ready to go the next time. You always want to gather your good chains back up again and put them back on the truck for the next time. But I cannot impress on you the need to practice. If you just watch this and don't do anything, when you're actually in a situation where you need to chain, you may hesitate. And I don't want you to have to do that. I want you to get out there and practice. Get a feel for it. Time yourself the first time. See how long it takes. Do it a second time. You'll find yourself doing it faster. Thank you.